Thank you. Mis mich entschuldigen für ein Kusch von Sibbe. Have to ask my apologies from each and every one of you who are sitting here learning. But the Zman Teure Lechid, Zman Tfile Lechid, Zman Achile Lechid. We have now completed our first Seder. It's 1 o'clock. We will go to lunch. And just before lunch, we will hear a few words from Rabbi Rosen, the founder of Eitaim. Truthfully, these speeches were meant to be given this morning and to start with the mission of Ma'amesai, but we saw the Toivli Toira Spicho, how the Oilam was learning, Mitazah Geshmak, Mitazah Eslavas. We didn't want to interrupt, we didn't want to disturb the Kol Toira. Chushev Etayri Yidin, Brichim Habuim, B'Shaim Hashem, Barachnichem, Ebayis Hashem. I think we can all say after learning this morning that since Sheshes Yimei Bereshis, since Briyas Oilam, there has never been such a gathering in Klal Yisrael as we had here this morning. Una gizmuas, ich weiß nicht, es ist amul zusammengekommen, azach ushe vetzibber, 400 Jiden, von alle Katzwei Hures, von alle Kreisen, from all parts and types of people. We have people who flew in from Eretz Yisrael, from London, from Manchester, from Detroit, all over the world, sitting under one roof, for one seal, for one goal, just to be mechazik, the couples who are waiting in Mitzapen Yeshia. Zal der Rebbeinu Shloilem helfen, alle Vayakai al Tov, Shinai, and Dalet. Today is Tez Zayin, or the Alef, which is Toiv. The Toiv li Toira Spicha should be Toiv, where the Rebbeinu Shloilem, when he created the man, he said, V'hinai Toiv Ma'oid. The Toiv li Toira Spicha should fall upon those couples who are waiting to have children and to be Zoicha to the Toiv Ma'oid. I want to be Messiah with a story. The story happened a few years ago in Eretz Yisrael. There was a Siyam Masechta, and the Magid Shia spoke and he said the following. Many years ago, there was a young man who didn't have children and he came to the Bris Karov, Zechroina Lebrocha, and he asked the Bris Karov should give him a brocha for children. And the Bris Karov is quiet for a second and he says to him, make a Siyam Masechta. Because b'shas is see a mesechta, it's a eis rotzen in Shemayim. B'shas, you complete a mesechta, is a eis rotzen in Himmel. And demels kest a poil na yeshia, and then you will be helped. This young man was no fool. And he found out when the brisker of himself is being mesayim a mesechta, and he walks in. And the brisker of asks him, what do you want? And he said, I heard that the rov is being mesayim a mesechta today. The Rav told me I should be Messiah, but I'm sure the Rav's chis is more than my chis. The Brisker Rav sagt, Inge Mann, bist a kliege Inge Mann. And er heißt ihm, er soll sich herupsetzen. And er gemacht im Siem, er getrinken an Al-Chaim. And 9 months later, this man had a boy. There were two people sitting in the crowd by the Siem. And one said to another, Mis nume gewinn zwei Chassidisch in Glad, einer rief sich uns zum Zweiten, noch am Maße. The Magid Shia heard the comment of these two Ingelat, and he turns around to one of the Ingelat and he says to him, Ingeman, do you have brothers? No. Ingeman, do you have schwesters? Do you have sisters? No. Do you know after how many years your parents waited until you were born? He said, yes, 12 years. He said to this Ingeman, go home and ask your father and mother whose blessing, whose bracha you were born. Who was the one who gave you the bracha? And he went home, and it was the story of the Brisker Rav. Moirai v'raboisai v'sim mesechta is a eis rotzen to help couples have children. Alachas kama v'kama today, that we are being Messiah the Shas, all under one roof. Avade in avade dusam moiridik ischis, fadi alapu felke v'svartn lehipukrit b'zere shel kayume, d'raibishe zol zay helfen. Therefore, I'm sure you all learned this morning mit a geschmack, mit a brenn. But when we come back after lunch and after mincha, we have our second Seder. Chushe v'tayre Yidin, we are here for one purpose, to be Messiah Shas Lizchis for all these couples who are waiting to have Zerah Shel Kayoma. Let's all have them in mind, and in Deim Zchis, let Rebbeinu Shloim bring the fears and yeshias v'ganz klal Yisrael umayin. I have this chis and honor and cover to call upon Rabbi Shaul Rosen, the founder of Eitayim, who dreams and thinks about Eitayim 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, what he can do for these couples. He's always coming up with new ideas, how to be mechazik the couples, how to help these couples. It is my honor and cover to call up Rabbi Shaul Rosen to come and address them choshev tzibur.
I don't have really much to say. It would be much easier to speak before seeing and before hearing the Kol Torah and the devotion that everyone has here today. But I'll try to do my best to give out a few words from the couples to the Olam over here today. But before I start, I'd like to repeat a story of Ramiah Shapiro. When Ramiah Shapiro came up with the idea of learning the daf every day, he went to the Chofetz Chaim, he asked the Chofetz Chaim to introduce the idea. And the Chofetz Chaim said no. He wants Ramiah Shapiro alone to introduce the idea. Ramiah Shapiro was afraid that people won't respect him and people won't be makabel the deer to learn the daf every single day. The Chofetz Chaim assured him everyone will respect him and asked him again that he should be the one to introduce the idea at the Asifa. Came to the time of the Asifa, the Chofetz Chaim sent a message to Ramiah Shapiro that he should please come in a little after everyone is sitting already. He should walk into the hall. And as Ramiah Shapiro walked into the hall and all the rabbunim and all the people from the Asifa were sitting there, Ramiah Shapiro, the Chofetz Chaim, got up, stood up for the Ramiah Shapiro, and automatically all the rabbunim and the whole Asifa stood up for Ramiah Shapiro, and he gained the respect of every person over there to hear his idea of what he wanted to present. When he got up to speak, he presented to the Olam the reason that he came up, why did he come up with this idea of learning the daf every day? And he said the following. He said, when a person learns a daf, and whole Klal Yisrael is going to learn the same daf every single day, is when a person travels from one place to another place, he'll have who to achava. When he comes over there, he'll find another yid learning the same sigur, learning the same gemurah, he'll always have someone to talk to. He'll always have another yid that he can relate to. I think the same thing is here today. We're here from all different types of backgrounds, are sitting in this room today, all for one reason, that another yid, that another couple, people that we don't even know, and people that you'll never know, that they should have what we all have, to see Doris Yeshurim Averuchim. I want to introduce somebody over here that came up with this whole idea. He's a Yiddid of mine. He's a Yiddid of mine for a lot of years and a bit of a time. He thought up this idea and he worked hard over the last 10 and a half months to make this idea a success. I would like if everyone could give a thank you to Yoel Wexler. I would like to give him a bracha. Yishevi zoiche, tebunim evnai bunim oiskim batoyle v'mitzvah samasim toivim. Thank you, Yoeli. I'm going to skip 3/4 of my speech and go to the end of the speech in regard to what the Siyum of Shas has to do with having kids. But before that, I want to be Magdam that the Masechta Bruchas is called Bruchas. But what does Bruchas mean? We see in Rashi, on the Brucha of Yerechechu Hashem v'yishmereichu, Rashi says, Yerechechu bebunem, v'yishmereichu bebunois. You see right away that Bruchas has to do with one thing, has to do with kids. Besides that, everything that we learn is in regard to kids. The Mishnah starts off with my aimes I couldn't shma be'aven. The Gemara says tana aichiku b'shachu v'kemeichu. But what does it say at the beginning of the pusik? It says v'shinantam levenechu. Before v'shinantam levenechu, you don't get to v'shachu v'kemeichu, and you don't get to start the Mishnah from my aimes I. Mishnah is a loosening from v'shinantam. That's what one of the pshatim are. Besides that is, every topic that is discussed by us Yidden, any article that is written, any drusha and besmedrish, any discussion between friends is based on one topic, on chinuch habunim and chinuch habunais. And for these couples that don't have that, they're missing their ikar part of giving over to the next generation. We see in the first Mishnah in Masechtas Bruchas, it says about the Benayram Gamliel. Why does it say about the Benayram Gamliel? Because everything is about giving over to the kids. If you don't have who to give it over to, then you're missing the most important ingredient in life. But it says, Avrum Avini leman yitzav ezbuna vezbaisa yachrov. The whole thing of Avrum Avini was, is he said he has no life without children. Because if you don't have who to give it over to, then you have nothing to live for. And that's what Torah is. Torah is Arua, where you give over for one for another, and you have to give it over from one door to the other door. And when you're missing that ingredient, that's why Torah, if we learn Torah, and there's Chis, then they'll be Zoiche to be able to learn Torah with their kids. I just want to touch on Mamish, two words over here, in regard to the people are really dedicated over here and really learning and really, I'm amazed. Are we really, really scared that people are going to be in the hallways drinking coffees and walking around and the oilam is mamash, such, everyone is giving themselves over with such heart, mamash belev eichad, that's sitting here learning. So I just want to say mamash two words and with that I finish. I don't think I have to be ma'oida the oilam any more than that. In the office of a time, when the phone rings and somebody calls in, it's usually when they call in, sometimes it's at the beginning, and sometimes it's after a long journey. And the pain and the tsar that you hear in the couple's voice, you can't interpret it into words to give it over to somebody else. It's an eternal pain, which you can listen to as the person is speaking, but it's not something you can duplicate. But I just want to give one example of the last week, what alone went through in the office. The Oilam should have understanding. Got a call last week from a couple in Geman who was after his 10th IVF and he failed. And what do you tell to somebody like this? He tried 10 times to have a child and 10 times he wasn't successful. And the truth is, we have seen people that after 10 times also have children. But what words can you tell him? And how can you be mechazikim the right way? And you know what he answered me? He answered me one word. He says, Sunday is going to give me chizik. Sunday is going to be the day that I know if I go to treatment, after Sunday, the Eibush is going to help me. That's the koyach that the Rabbim has here today. To give in to everybody that the Me'etz Hashem, through koyach HaTorah, that they'll be helped. And Me'etz Hashem, the Taka will be helped. The Eibush should help. They should all be zoiche. Today is Yishuv Mevaruchim. I'm not going to keep the oilam. I'm a little lost in my words over here. And we should all be zoiche to have naches from our kids and see Doris from Shulam Baruchim. Thank you so much.